Introducing the 2017 Maserati Levante, a stunning yet very capable entry into the luxury SUV segment. Maserati has a storied history that dates back to 1914, and while they have built some amazing cars in the past, 2017 brought their first SUV. The exterior of the Levante grabs everyone's attention, from the bold front grille with Maserati's signature trident emblem to the three portholes on the front fenders to the rear spoiler. The Levante is distinctive and sets itself apart from its competition. 21-inch alloy wheels and the optional yellow brake calipers complete an exterior look that is sure to attract a crowd at every stop. Levante comes standard with a Ferrari-built 345-horse 3-liter V6 twin-turbo engine, but my review vehicle is the S model that bumps that horsepower up to 424 horses and 428 pound-feet of torque that'll take you to 60 miles an hour in 5 seconds flat. All Levantes come with the Q4 all-wheel drive system and an outstanding 8-speed ZF transmission that you can shift from very large paddles on the steering wheel or from the stick shifter in the console. This transmission shifts hard and fast under heavy acceleration. Maserati is known for fantastic interiors, and from the moment you open the driver's door, you know you're entering a very special vehicle. The leather seats look soft and comfortable, and you're welcomed by the Maserati logo on the front and rear headrest. The first thing that grabbed my attention was the steering wheel. It's carbon fiber and leather and is not only the best looking steering wheel I've ever seen, it also feels the best. As you look through that steering wheel, you see a 190 mile per hour speedometer on the left and a tachometer on the right, both surrounded by cylinders to provide shade from the sun. In the center is a very colorful driver info center that is controlled on the steering wheel. You can scroll from the main menu where the digital speedometer is to vehicle info, drive mode, driver assist options, fuel economy, trip data, start-stop options, audio info, stored messages, and finally vehicle settings. To the left of the power tilt wheel is the start button. Between the seats is a carbon fiber center console where the shifter is, the knob to control the infotainment system, and buttons along the left side to change the drive modes. There's also a switch to adjust the Levante to 5 different ride heights. There is a covered compartment ahead of the shifter, and behind it is your armrest that doubles as a storage area. By the way, the center storage area and the glove box are both air conditioned. Above the console in the center stack is an 8.4-inch very vivid display that operates everything in the SUV. It's funny, but I immediately recognized it as very similar to the Chrysler Uconnect system, which I often say is the best system in the industry. In case you didn't know, Fiat Chrysler owns Maserati and Ferrari, but I digress. The screen can be used by touch, or unlike the Chrysler system, you can use a knob in the center console. You can control the radio, media, seat controls, climate, navigation system, and sync your phone. In the middle of that row of buttons, touch the Maserati Trident and it takes you to the app section. Among other things, there are apps for the heated and air-conditioned seats, travel link with real-time traffic, weather, fuel prices, movie listings, and sports scores. You can also change the settings on the rearview camera, which is one of the best I've ever seen. All in all, you can learn the Maserati touch system in a matter of minutes. By the way, the system is compatible with both Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. Now, wrapping up on the inside, rich stitching and carbon fiber is everywhere. I found nothing plastic anywhere. I love the sport pedals and the illuminated door seals. Back seat and headroom were surprisingly ample, and there's 19.4 cubic feet of cargo area with the second row seat up. As you would expect in a luxury SUV, it comes completely loaded with standard equipment like parking sensors, blind spot monitoring, hands-free liftgate, remote start, LED daytime running lights, bi-xenon headlights, and a panoramic sunroof. My tester came with a little over $21,000 in options. It has the $3,000 driver assistance package, which gets you adaptive cruise control, forward collision warning, lane departure warning, and the surround view camera. $2,080 gets you the sport package and includes the 21-inch wheels, the rear spoiler, 12-way power sport seats, and the sport pedals. Some of the other options include the $5,200 17-speaker Bowers & Wilkins surround sound system with 1,250 watts of sound. The carbon fiber trim runs $2,850. Steering wheel sets you back a grand. Yellow calipers are $300. Air conditioned seats are $900. And power rear door glass screens cost $450. The Levante is a true joy to drive, and you can completely change the way the SUV rides and handles with the four different sport modes. The M button is manual sport mode, which requires you to use the paddle shifters. The ICE button stands for increased control and efficiency, similar to the Eco button in other vehicles for better fuel economy. Then my favorite is Sport. This unleashes an amazing exhaust sound that's like no other I've ever driven. Hit the Sport button twice and everything changes to turn up the power, handling, and performance. It is amazing the difference. Last is the Off-Road button, which raises the vehicle automatically and allows the driver to concentrate on driving whether going uphill or downhill in rough terrain. The Levante in Sport mode is a true sports car dressed up like an SUV. Its perfect 50-50 weight distribution makes handling amazing. This SUV has incredible acceleration and a balanced ride. Or if you leave the sport mode off, you can enjoy a true luxury ride. This SUV is incredibly quiet inside. The performance and interior is nothing short of amazing. Not that anybody cares, it's rated at 14 city and 19 highway with a combined rating of 16 miles per gallon. Of course, all this wonderfulness comes at a price. Total MSRP on this luxury SUV is $106,200, which is in line with its competitors, the Range Rover Sport, BMW X5, and Porsche Cayenne when comparably equipped. If you're going to spend six figures on a very unique luxury performance SUV, the Levante deserves a hard look. And if you drive it, I can almost guarantee you'll buy it. Thanks for riding along with us today for another CarPro test drive. This week, testing the 2017 Maserati Levante S.